All right, buddies. I believe we are live. E3 2019, Microsoft press conference. I'm trying to get this loaded up here in a way that you guys can see. We don't want any of the corners getting cut off. Hope too much. How is that?
There's a significant chance we will see Microsoft show off its first next-gen console today. So what do we expect to see, assuming it's in the show? We're just about to see the first next-gen console, or at least get some details about it.
Yeah? I feel like they have to. Yeah? You know, Sony's out, and Microsoft's been hyping this up for so long, like, it's going to be our biggest conference ever. So I expect a name. I expect far more than a name.
All right. I think we're good. I think we're live.
Say, hey, this is what we're doing for next-gen. If we can finish, bring these great games in like a very new way to you, and so I have again high expectations.
Yeah.
And they sent them for me, so you know.
What about you, Ryan? You have high expectations?
Oh, absolutely. Microsoft really went all in on the whole marketing tagline of world's most powerful console with the Xbox One X, and there's no way they're just going to walk away from that and be like, well, here's our next-gen console, hope you like it. They're going to be leaning into that hard and doing everything they can to make everybody believe that they've got the big bucks. But I disagree with Miranda. I think next E3 is the time for the name, the price, the release date, but I think we'll learn a lot of other things, a lot of technical details. I don't think we're ready for name yet. I think it's too early.
The reason I want it now is because I want them to put this out in spring next year.
I would like to get the name and the price now. I want to know now what we're going to be paying,
Spend this out.
Where?
Also, get me this sooner.
Okay, so I'm gonna be right here.
No release date, no price.
Not a specific release date, and definitely not a price. Absolutely too early for that. But technical specs, hopefully a Halo Infinite demo showing what the console is.
Absolutely,
we'll get that.
Do you think Halo Infinite is a next gen game?
I think it's their day one launch game.
Yeah, I agree.
Launched with a Halo since the first Xbox.
Yep.
And the 360 had the year had started. Didn't really matter. They really could have used the Halo launch of Xbox One. I think this time,
I gotta make my team.
Chamber and Halo launch is the signature day one launch game.
It's getting close.
We've also talked so much about how Halo is supposed to be like a spiritual reboot and kind of evoking everything that you got from the feeling of the original Halo, and mirroring on any way possible, I think it's just going to be better for Microsoft.
If you remember a few E3s ago when they really revealed the Scorpio, that was via a pre-taped video of a bunch of people at Microsoft talking about how they were making the most powerful console of all time. So maybe that's what we'll see today for Stardust. Does that seem like it?
Good chance, I think.
Yeah, I would agree with that.
Though we never did get that VR headset that they talked
about. they should talk about VR too. Alright, Microsoft is working on a slew of first party games. We'll get to the big ones like Gears and Halo in just a second. But first, let's talk what Ninja Theory could be working on. There was a leak about that already, right? A new multiplayer game?
Yeah, which I wasn't expecting at all.
Yeah.
So we have Hellblade on right now. And it looks so different tonally from that. It's like this very bright, poppy, if this is a true leak, 4v4 action, and it's very colorful, and everyone just, the character designs are very wacky.
Yeah.
And like they keep flashing, like, DMC, like we made DMC once, kind of thing. And you can kind of see why they're kind of pulling on that tonally. That would be different, not really expected.
Yeah. And word is that this game, Bleeding Edge, by the way, is a second team. There's a couple teams there, so for anybody that sort of has a preemptive reaction of, Microsoft's never going to make a single player focused game. This was evidently in the works prior to the Microsoft acquisition, and there's a second team that is drawing up, some untold new thing.
I feel like that's very important context. I'm super glad you brought that up, because it definitely, when I saw the leak, I was kind of like, wow, that's so interesting that they're coming out and they're doing 4v4. Not even something with a multiplayer component, like it is a 4v4 game. Theoretically, maybe, if it's right.
What about Ori and the Will of the Wisps? I think E3 last year was the last time we saw that game, wasn't it?
They were on our Gamescom stage.
Oh,
yeah.
Gamescom.
Yeah.
They revealed a new mode there as well.
I think it's something trials. It's a time trials situation. But I want this game so bad. I want it in my hand.
I want to go out on a limb. This will be one of my easy predictions to hold me to one way or the other. I think that gets out today.
Oh, that's so great. I agree with that.
Totally radio silent on it. Gears 5 is their big fall title. And yeah. Not that they can't have more than one big fall title, but I think today is the day, and maybe we'll get to play Ori today.
That'd be awesome.
Yeah, all right. I love the first game. Really been excited. Second, it seems like it's been a long time in development, this one. This is great. What about Battletoads? That was announced last year.
They've got to show it this year. So that's Rare is working. The primary development work is being. sort of an earlier segment, this is the flagship game for the next gen Xbox that we're going to talk about. I think we might see substantial content from Halo Infinite, and I could not be more excited for this because, you know, a new Halo is, it's normally been every 3 years, but now it's, we're looking at like 5 years, so the anticipation has built up even more, and I'm so ready. I want to love this game so badly. I got torched by the awful Halo 5 campaign, which was offset by the awesome multiplayer, but I need a good Halo campaign, and please let this be it.
I believe. I want to believe at least. I mean, that extra time is so important, right? Like, they are... 343 Industries just said, hey, we want to make this right. We've heard what you said about the last campaign. We heard that you want to focus on Chief. And I think they could have done Locke better if they just would have given him a character. Like, if he was a character and not just a guy hunting someone down. Anyway, that's a whole other
story. Yeah, we don't have time.
But, yeah, you know, we don't. And I think they have heard and they are paying attention. Like, we're getting a four-player co-op again. There's a lot of things there.
That's great.
Yes, that's great. It's so important. And I have faith that they will do us right this time.
New console, new engine,
yes.
Spiritual reboot, and focus on Chief.
Yes,
let's go, Chief.
Really, just said that other piece. I do think we're gonna get some cinematic like story stuff. If it follows the trend of reveals for Halo 5, which is like they start kind of getting into the story elements.
Oh my
gosh, we're sitting for it.
Well, I mean, I'm hoping for gameplay, but I don't think we'll get it. I do think that we will get kind of a tonal cinematic trailer. I would imagine that, I think Ryan, you said this earlier, that they'll use Halo to show off kind of, oh my gosh, I'm totally thinking.
Anaconda,
yes,
Scarlet Family.
Kind of show off what it can do. And anything that they show us, I will be happy with, because, and to echo what I said earlier, I want them to be ready to show us things. Like, I'm not in a hurry, take your time, just make sure that when you do show us, and when you put the game out, that it is absolutely incredible. Like, I want this to blow me away.
Yeah, absolutely.
There's really, I really feel like there's a lot riding on this Halo for Microsoft. I mean, there is on every Halo. It's their premier game, but, you know, after 5 was roundly criticized for the campaign, 4 I thought was pretty unfairly criticized by a lot of people just because 343 wasn't Bungie. Master Chief Collection had well-documented problems. There's so much riding on this game for Microsoft.
Can you say spiritual reboot? Like, what does that mean to you? Do you think previous events have even happened in this game?
They have confirmed story. It's same story. There is no narrative reset of any kind. We're picking up where we left off, which I'm very interested to see how they manage that from the end of Halo 5. But you clearly see in the teaser that we've been rolling from last year, you know, his armor is more Halo 1, Halo 2 looking. There's an art direction reset.
Yeah, just all the presentation invokes that Halo 1 feel.
Yes.
And that's what we were saying before, and I think that's really what they were going for. It's like the spiritual reboot in the fact that they're taking a few steps back and looking what they did with the original Halo and trying to evoke those feelings while progressing everything forward.
Sure.
Yeah. You do.
Well,
your job.
I was just gonna say, looking a little bit nearer on the horizon to Gears 5, what do we hope to see today from Gears 5, and will we get a release date?
I feel like we have to get a release date, right? Like, what else would they tell us it's coming out?
Other
events, but I would prefer it to be a...
Right, well, as a fan, I'm kind of like, well, like, you have to.
Right.
Yeah, kind of also coming back to Microsoft being like, this is our biggest E3 ever. Like, we want that information as well, and I think that's part of that expectation.
And last year, a lot of games at the Xbox conference got release dates. Gears 5, they just said 2019, and so fast forward 1 year, it is 2019. I will eat this microphone. Not at release date.
That would be
on this conference.
So I got So it's most likely to be Xbox's big fall game this year. Or is this actually going to be the last big Xbox One game?
That's kind of what I'm feeling in my gut.
Yeah, I mean, I feel like at least first party.
Yeah, it's all the new studios that they acquired, which they went over, you know, that was a big part of last year's conference. Those are not like band-aid fixes. You don't just buy a studio and then they overnight make a new game that's a headliner of your first party effort. It's a long process, and it was all done with next gen in mind. So, you know, yeah, we talked about the Ninja Theory rumor/leak from earlier, but and then Ori is still out there, whether it comes out today or not. But yeah, as far as like the big AAA stuff, yeah, there's no way that like Fable comes back for this gen. I think Gears 5 is the you know, quadruple A swan song for the Xbox One.
And then along with the release date, what do you expect to actually see today? So I think they've already said they're not going to show PvP gameplay, is that right? They're saving that for later?
Correct. That is for their E-League mini-series. So it's like a six-part series, and then it's going to end with a tournament where they have pro players showing off Gears 5's multiplayer.
Which I believe that's Friday, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, it's very soon.
Yeah, it's not like we're going to have to wait like months.
Yeah, so we'll get to see what Versus looks like for Gears 5.
Yeah.
So we at least know that's off the table. So we still have Horde, we obviously still have the campaign.
Yeah. Can I just say real quick, I genuinely think, I know we're on an Xbox pre-show right now, I really think that Gears is a criminally underrated franchise in gaming. Like, the campaign's always been great, the Versus has always been great, Horde's always been great, but this is a great series that I feel like not enough people
Though, because I've never really seen Gears as being not loved. Do you mean just like not to the extent that like maybe Halo is?
Yes. I really feel like that's okay.
That's true. Yeah, because I think they've been critically well received.
Sure.
I don't have the sales numbers, but I would imagine they sell pretty well for Xbox too. So.
Well, do you think, again, please stop me because I don't want to derail the pre-show too much into like a Gears of War analysis. But do you think that it's kind of a learning curve to get into the mechanics of the PvP is so steep? Like, it's not the friendliest game to get into and really get into a group. You can play it, you can shoot things, cool, but I feel like understanding the cover-based mechanics and or the cover movements is hard.
Yeah.
It's hard to make that feel good.
But even then, like, it's not all just about PvP, right? Like, Horde is excellent.
Yeah.
And then the campaign is excellent. So you have two massive parts of this game that aren't just bad.
I mean, Fortnite's weird to get into if you've never played it, right?
That's true. I mean, I'm just trying to think of why people maybe aren't as quick to latch onto it.
Yeah. I mean, maybe it's also, like, an assumption about the tone of it, because it is, like, beefy guys doing things, there's a lot of blood, but it's just so full of heart though.
Yeah.
And like, that's the hard thing. It's like, if you talk to anybody, they'll say like, yes, this is about found family and there's so much love here and it's great drama, but also chainsaws. I love that.
All right, we are just minutes away from the Xbox.
So it begins, my friends. So it begins. Let's go. There it is. E3 2019. Alright, are we good? I think so. Alright, Halo Infinite last. That's what I'm thinking. Last. It's the last thing in the show. My one prediction.
This is the Xbox E3 2019 reveal.
Everything we have, everything we are.
I'm too far away, I'm getting my team.
We owe to them. They are always with us. No one has ever gone against them.
Why is the quality so terrible?
A stranger has just arrived. Someone who's challenging the corporate war. Who's digging up their secrets?
Alright. This isn't gonna fly.
Someone who could be a villain. Or a hero.
Looks like the bleeding stopped. I owe you one. Here, hope this gun serves you better than a
dick. HD, huh?
Or a psychopath.
You know what?
Oh.
There we go. I'm wondering if it's in 4K on the YouTube.
I suppose time will tell, but no matter who this stranger chooses to be, the Halcyon colony will never be the same.
See if I can find
Xbox Game Studios,
the YouTube one.
A move that's given us an incredible boost in achieving the creative ambition of our teams. We've started work on a number of new games at the studio, and in the near future, we'll be sharing details on all of these projects.
Yeah.
When we joined Xbox Game Studios, we already had a very exciting game several years in the making. We're happy to return to E3 and share this with you.
As creative director, I'm stoked to be here to share our new game with you guys. It combines two of my gaming passions, third-person action combat and competitive team multiplayer. Our technical alpha is kicking off in just a couple of weeks, and we'd love for you to
start to E3 to share this with you.
Or if you're here at E3,
as creative director, I'm stoked to be here to share a new game with you guys. It combines two of my gaming passions, third-person action combat and competitive team multiplayer. Our technical alpha is kicking off in just a couple of weeks.
Oh my God. My God. Would you look at that?
We'd love for you to sign up, get involved, and tell us what you think. Or if you're here at E3, come join us for a game.
Is it the first time we see 2020s?
Please welcome the head of Xbox.
Spencer. He is.
Is it recording? Phil. You're the man, Phil.
Okay. Thank you. We on Team Xbox live for this exact moment.
Yes, let's go.
The moment we get to share the best of our art form here with you in LA. And the moment you get to experience breathtaking new stories, new worlds, and new heroes for the very first time. This moment isn't just about finding some new games, it's about discovering your new games. This decisive moment of discovery is etched in your gaming history, alongside your every achievement, your every moment, your every new friend. This is why we on Team Xbox are always and will be dedicated to unleashing the next new games for you to discover and love. So whether you're one of the thousands with us here in Microsoft Theater,
Jam-packed, dude. Like, all the seats are filled, though.
Welcome to E3 2019. This right now is the single most creative and energizing time in gaming history.
Yes.
Games and gamers together now have the sheer magnitude to be a significant unifying force for the world.
Unifying, let's go, Phil!
The expanding universe of gaming has opened a new era of creative possibility. With more games, more creators, and more industry players than ever before. And gamers were everywhere. In under two decades, the number of players in the world has more than tripled. Over 2 billion of us now play games in every region and on every continent.
Yes.
And with new technological leaps, we get to play whatever we want, with whomever we want, and wherever we want. On Team Xbox, every decision is guided by our belief that gaming is for everyone. My team and I are single-minded in our resolve to bring everyone the games they want, to connect everyone to play with the friends they want, and to empower everyone to play whatever they want.
It's like a brain.
This is why we keep innovating hardware and services. It's why we're uniting communities through crossplay, and it's why we're investing with new distinctive creators. Above all, gaming is for you. This is why we scour the world for your next new games. This today is the largest showcase of games on any stage, anywhere this year.
Okay. Old claims. But not too much. This soda's not
today,
even on the stage.
From the thousands of games in development across Xbox One and Windows PC, we're highlighting 60 games for you.
60. Let's go.
Including 14 games from Xbox Game Studios, and over 30 games premiering in Xbox Game Pass. In addition to showcasing all of these games over the show, we'll also announce what's next at Xbox Game Studios.
Yes, what's next? Let's go.
Share our expansive plans for streaming. And of course,
streaming.
Revealing more about our next new console.
New console.
So thank you for joining us today. Let's jump in.
Let's go. Jump in. I love it. It's good. Good intro, Phil. Excellent at the end.
With Star Wars right away?
Okay. Let's see. What do you got?
Yeah.
Cal Kestis.
Sobre.
You're a Jedi business.
Jedi dead.
Yes, please.
Okay, boy. Let's find this kid.
Oh my god.
Wait, look, boy. Boy!
Jesse, Brady Bad.
money. This is not getting, it's not gameplay. But the gameplay will look good. We saw the gameplay a year ago. It was nowhere near like this. It's a lot better. Oh my god. I'm guessing 2020 fall.
Corporal cop in this city's gonna be blasting down these doors after what you and your psycho friends did.
It looks so good. Might be the greatest movie I've ever seen. Yeah, I hate to say it. Keanu Reeves just shows up. What? Neo? Look at everybody! Everybody's up! Dude, yes. Is that Keanu Reeves Neo? No! 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 Neo just shows up! The one! Oh my god, dude. What? Look at this. The Matrix, guys, if you haven't seen The Matrix, finish this and then go watch it, all three of them. Dude, thank you later. Change your life.
Good to see you. Thank you.
Oh my god, what?
Alright.
I gotta talk to you about something.
CD Projekt Red.
That was, dude, I don't know.
Cyberpunk 2077. Alright. A while back, the guys from CD Projekt Red approached me and asked me to be a part of their new project, Cyberpunk 2077. They were going on and on about how they create this vast open world with a branching storyline. How you'd be able to customize your character through in-game choices. And it's not something I knew before, but I was excited.
Please.
And I'm always drawn to fascinating stories.
Neo.
Cyberpunk. It's set in a metropolis of the future, where body modification has become an obsession. Yeah. You play as an outlaw, an enhanced mercenary working in the sleazy underbelly of the city. Yeah.
Let me tell you,
the feeling of being there, of walking the streets of the future, is really going to be breathtaking. You're breathtaking.
The girls, you hear them screaming? You hear them screaming.
Do you guys want to know
when it comes out?
When the release date?
Yes, dude. 2020 fall, spring. I say fall. All right. Do it
for the. Then check this out.
Okay, 420 almost. Okay.
premiere.
Like, this stuff can't handle it. Are you kidding me? That trailer we saw, I was like, oh my god. Ah, little indie game. That's why you don't want spoilers, guys. You know, you want to protect yourself from spoilers as much as you can in your life, but everything, because the universe is made up of infinite possibilities, and at any time, anything or anyone could approach you or anything could happen. But if you know exactly what's going to happen, who's showing up, what's going to win now, whatever, then you literally collapse infinity, the potential of anything, you collapse it into one reality, into that one. So if I would have, like, looked this up or somehow had a lead and been like, oh, like, Neo's coming, then I would have been sitting here being like, oh yeah, I know Neo's showing up, I just don't know when. Like, I'm expecting him already. But I had no idea, so I didn't look it up and I had no clues. Therefore, there was infinite possibilities about who could have showed up, what could have happened. And that's what happened. They brought up the Matrix, they brought up Neo. Oh my god. The joy that you feel. The joy that you feel is indescribable. So at all times, avoid spoilers. For your brain, for your psyche. Not Battletoads. The Battletoads. Yeah. Not my thing, but some other people. That was very good at all. At all. It's like a PlayStation 2. So how long do we think the show is going to be? I'd say anywhere from hour to 2 hours. So, yes, I'm gonna say an hour and a half. Put it right in the middle of that. The Legend of the Dragons. What? Is it Goku on the left and Peach on the right? What is this?
Xbox games you just saw will premiere on Xbox Game Pass day one. At Xbox, our passion is to help you find and play the games that you love through creation, curation, and discovery. The ultimate expression of that passion is Xbox Game Pass. My team travels the globe, seeking out fan favorites and hidden gems, and crafts partnerships with their creators so that you can discover your next favorite game. Mind-blowing experiences, epic adventures, and iconic characters, all for you to explore. It has been awesome to see the record-breaking success developers have had in Xbox Game Pass, introducing their games to new players and creating lifelong fans. Since launch, we have tripled the number of partners in Game Pass, adding more games from more genres, platformers, RPG, adventure, sports, puzzles, and more every single month. And of course, every Xbox Game Studios title you see today will premiere in Game Pass day one.
What does that mean, day one? Did they say what day one is?
We are thrilled to announce new titles coming to Xbox Game Pass on console today, including Batman Arkham Knight, Metro Exodus, Hollow Knight, and Borderlands The Handsome Collection. Amazing games that you can start playing today. Our mission at Xbox is for you to be able to play any game with anyone, anywhere. And we know for many of you that means PC.
That is why,
last month, we announced Xbox Game Pass for PC. Today, the Game Pass journey on PC begins. Now, PC players can discover their next favorite game with Xbox Game Pass. We have curated over 100 games just for PC, including favorites like Imperator Rome and Football Manager 2019. And for the first time on PC, starting with Halo Reach, the entire Master Chief Collection.
Yep.
We are thrilled to share that Xbox Game Pass for PC launches in open beta today.
Oh? That doesn't mean Halo is open beta.
Game Pass for PC is here now. Try it out by downloading the all-new Xbox app on Windows. And if you want it all, we have created a membership just for you. Xbox Game Pass Ultimate.
Mm-hmm. Maybe you can keep the games.
You get everything. Xbox Game Pass for console with over 100 great games, Xbox Live Gold, an unrivaled gaming community, and now, Xbox Game Pass for PC
at no additional charge. And because it's E3, everyone can jump in and play today for $1.
Nice. Interesting.
Now go discover your next favorite game.
Ooh. I play probably much more to this.
Do you remember a time when armies were built and powerful cities collapsed? When the smallest of choices echoed through the pages of history? It was an age of empires.
I see you at Donkey's Ace. Welcome to beautiful Colorado. Home to the Purple Mountains of Ecstasy. Of the Rockies. Hike through colorful canyons. Get up close and personal with the wild and woolly wildlife. Sample home-cooked delicacies. Eat where the locals eat. Visit Colorado Springs. So much to see and do in this post-apocalyptic winter wonderland. Meet new people, make new friends. Colorado has colorful characters and friendly faces everywhere you look. See our beautiful airport. And don't forget to pick yourself up a nifty souvenir.
Games are at the heart of our mission. Over the last year,
We added 7 new game development studios to Xbox. It's fantastic to see some of these studios already sharing new games on our E3 stage, and there's more to come. I have the privilege of working with some of the best studios around the globe. And for me, great studios are about people, teams, and ideas. Our success comes down to one thing: creating great games that players love. And great games come from great developers. That's why I'm honored today to announce that joining Xbox Studios is Double Fine Productions. Double Fine has been a beacon of creativity and spirit in game development for almost 20 years, with classic games like Psychonauts, Brutal Legend, and Broken Age. I'm looking forward to Double Fine joining Xbox and seeing what we create together. Please join me in welcoming the founder and president of Double Fine Productions, Tim Schafer.
Thank you, Matt. We are so excited to be joining Xbox Game Studios, and I'm here to personally reassure you, Matt, I don't know what you've heard, but I'm a team player. Whatever you need from Double Fine, we'll make for you. Halo stuff, Forza stuff, Excel stuff, whatever you want, we are there.
So yeah.
Money talks. We just want you to make great games.
Oh, that's such a relief, that's my line. In that case, we brought a brand new trailer for Psychonauts 2. Take a look if you dare!
Dragon Ball. Akira Toriyama. Oh my god. Project Z, come on.
Thank you.
god! Oh my god! Yes. Kakarot is what it's called. Early 2020, let's go. Yes. Yes.
World premiere.
Oh, that music. But I don't know, I want to see more gameplay where you can just like run around, like you can run around the world and stuff.
My father died
of a heart attack?
No, I didn't have anything to do with...
Any second now, he's gonna knock on that door. Help me.
This isn't happening. This can't be happening.
Police, open up.
That's him.
Did you call the police?
We have a warrant. Please open the door.
I didn't do anything.
We're here to help.
Don't listen to him. I'm your only chance.
Open the door, right now.
You know me. I love you. But you have to believe me.
Stop.
No.
I'm your arrest.
You're home. What are you doing? Are you okay?
Thank you.
From the Coalition, please welcome Studio Head Rod Ferguson.
Thanks, everyone. We're excited to announce that Gears 5 is releasing on September 10th. And if you want to play 4 days early, you can with our Ultimate Edition or membership in the newly announced Xbox Game Pass Ultimate. With Gears of War 4, we wanted to earn your trust. But with Gears 5, we want to push the envelope by doing new things never seen in a Gears game before. And we'll tell you all about it this summer. In July, join us for our Versus Multiplayer Tech Test, where you'll be one of the first to play our all-new competitive game type, Arcade. In August at Gamescom, go hands-on with the all-new Horde mode and see how character abilities can turn the tide on the battlefield. In September, we return to the biggest Gears campaign ever, where we'll explore more of Kate's harrowing journey and celebrate our launch on September 10th. But what are we talking about today? Today, it's a brand new way to fight the swarm. In Escape, you play as one of three Hivebusters. You and your squad infiltrate the hive, plant the bomb, and escape with your life. Because we all know the best defense is a good offense. It's everything you love about Gears, turned up to 11.
Could have been so much cooler with different music here.
taste of escape, an aggressive three-player co-op experience, perfect for your living room couch. But it's not just about busting hives. You can build them too, and challenge your friends with the experiences you create. And tonight, join me on Mixer as we challenge these three WWE superstars, Xavier Woods, AJ Styles, and Tyler Breeze, to survive a gameplay deep dive from right here in the Hive. For these at home, for the next 2 days, you and your friends can play in select Microsoft stores. So good luck at running the swarm, and we'll see you on the leaderboards. Oh, and for anyone who pre-orders or plays within the first week, we've got something special just for you.
New controller. Oh god, the Elite 2. Oh god. Tell me about the lanes. Yes, 2. Yes. Let's go, baby. Hope it's lighter. Order here, triggers.
Saved my life. He told me never forget who I am, where I come from. But in this place, nobody even wants to know my name. Getting attached is death. Because when darkness comes, I might be gone. Tore society apart, but I won't let it turn me into an enemy. Staying alive became the essence of our existence, yet life must be more than just survival. Every day, the disease tries to crush us and make us forget who we are, but I keep fighting. My name is Aiden, and I am infected. World premiere.
Thank you.
Legos.
Incredible life-size Lego Speed Champions McLaren Senna. Combine the beauty and freedom of Horizon with the playful fun of Lego, you get the Forza Horizon 4 Lego Speed Champions expansion. You will drive this Senna and more Lego Speed Champions cars in an entirely new world, packed with inventive new challenges, new areas to explore, and loads of bricks to smash. The Forza Horizon 4 LEGO Speed Champions expansion launches this week. I'll see you there.
world premiere.
Those of you who have played Phantasy Star know that this game has influenced many of the most popular games today. So with great delight, we welcome Sega back to our stage and Phantasy Star back on Xbox. As we said, our goal on Team Xbox is to bring you the world's best games. Meeting with developers, playing their games, and introducing you to their games, these are the best parts of my job. Back at E3 2017, when I first met with the creators of this next game, they shared their ambition to bring their massively popular game with its passionate community of 650 million PC players to the entire world. I'm happy to announce our partnership with the legendary team at Smilegate. Their approach to game design demonstrates sheer creative boldness. Next year, you'll discover the newest entry in this landmark franchise. On console, for the very first time, only on Xbox. This is Crossfire X.
World premiere. world premiere.
In the universe. I used to be one of them. My name is Lilith, and I need you.
World premiere.
Miyazaki, what? Resident Evil? Oh, this is the one, FromSoft. Oh my god, the Elden, whatever. The Elden, yes. Yes, horror, yes.
I doubt you could even imagine it.
From multinational studios to one-person passion projects, thousands of Xbox games are in development for you right now. Just today, we showed you 60 games. We are now experiencing an unmatched expansion of creativity on Xbox.
It's an hour and a half.
Gaming for you means connecting all of these creators to all of you. Last fall, we announced our ambition to empower everyone everywhere to play by bringing Xbox to the cloud. We will do this in two ways, through Project xCloud and through console streaming. 2 months ago, we connected all Xbox developers to Project xCloud. Today, we invite those of you here at E3 for our first public hands-on of Project xCloud. To experience the freedom to play right here at the show. And you'll have two ways to stream. There's a new platform feature, console streaming. It turns your Xbox One into your own personal and free xCloud server. Whether you're using a console in our data center or your console at home, this October, you'll be able to use our hybrid gaming cloud to play your games wherever you go. Where you play is now entirely your choice. You decide. So let's talk about our next console.
Oh, God.
For us, the console is vital and central to our experience. We heard you. A console should be designed and built and optimized for one thing and one thing only, gaming.
Yes. Let's go, baby.
So the same team that created the world's most powerful console, Xbox One X, and innovated its groundbreaking processor and the Elite controller, the same team that engineered the world-class compatibility of today's Xbox One console.
What's it called, dude?
The same team that set the bar for live gaming services with Xbox Live, this same team set out on a new mission.
Xbox Infinity.
To create the future of gaming for you.
When you think about the future of gaming, concept art? It's not just PC, it's not just console, it's not just mobile. It's really all of the above.
Xbox is all about choice. We're investing in technology all throughout the game stack.
The games you want with the people you want on the devices that you want.
And for us, that starts with our next generation console.
Well, they're gonna show us this concept art.
Build just another console. We truly want it to be transformative.
Oh my God. I hope it looks different.
More details.
Please. How do we make it easier for people to get into the game, to stay in the game?
One of the things that gamers and developers are incredibly excited about is reducing load times. Yes. I'm an RPG gamer, and so loading screens are a thing. Sitting there in the fake elevator because you know that the game's loading in the background. It's just an elevator ride forever. That's our goal with gaming, is that you don't have those pauses.
This generation is going to be a bigger leap than any generation we've done before. At the heart of our next generation console is our custom design processor, leveraging the latest Zen 2 and Navi technology from our partners at AMD.
Navi.
From a pure processing perspective, this is 4 times more powerful than the Xbox One X. We're leveraging high bandwidth GDDR6 to ensure that we're getting the best performance possible.
It's gonna usher in resolution and frame rates that we've never seen before.
We're looking at frame rates up to 120 frames per second.
8K capability, variable refresh rate.
Next gen ray tracing. It's real time because it's hardware accelerated for the first time ever.
What I'm personally most excited about is the SSD.
We've created a new generation of SSDs. We're actually using the SSD as virtual RAM. We're seeing more than 40 times performance increases over the current generation.
The combination of the SoC and the solid-state drive are really what gives you a totally new experience.
Now you can take all that power and apply it back into the
the scene.
What's the controller like?
You actually generate more life in that world. What's and bring it to the gamer in a seamless way, so that then you're fully experiencing what the game developer wants you to experience.
When you can move through worlds without waiting for screens to load, that speed, that performance is what the next generation is about.
This is the most immersive console experience ever.
What we really want to do is give developers the power to build the game they've always envisioned.
We have hundreds of people across both our first-party studios as well as our third-party studios working on those next-generation experiences today.
It's an amazing commitment to content at Xbox Game Studios. 13 studios, 7 in the last year. That's a big family.
At 343, for us, it's always about more seamless worlds with the next generation. We can bring the world to life in a way we've never experienced Halo before.
Delivering 4 generations of content better than you've ever seen them before.
This console is especially awesome for Game Pass members. With the faster load times, you're going to be able to experience all the games within just snap your fingers.
We're giving gamers the option to connect across devices and across platforms in a way that we never were able to before.
This isn't just a console launch. This is about the future of gaming.
2024 achievements, your progression, your accessories, your console gaming experience with Xbox, it all comes forward.
What's it called? Scarlet? Is that the call in it? Project Scarlet, okay. Okay. Okay, yeah, I like it. Holiday 2020, let's go!
Eat monsters for breakfast.
Let's go. I love that name. I'm so glad they stuck with it. Everyone's saying other things. I love Scarlet.
The most powerful and highest performing console we've ever designed. Built for creators to unleash their boldest creative visions. And optimized for players to enjoy the ultimate gaming experience on a console anywhere. Immersive experiences begin at the very heart of the console, at the silicon level itself. Together with our partners at AMD, we have co-engineered and custom designed a state-of-the-art processor for Project Scarlet.
I love the name. So maybe
power you
could
see
later,
define previous generation.
Don't announce it.
Power and performance you can see and feel defines Project Scarlet. When we talk about freedom to play, when we talk about Xbox in the cloud, when we talk about streaming your games, Project Scarlet and all of its power and all of its performance is the foundation of our future in console and the formation of our future in cloud. We launched Xbox 18 years ago with a game reviewers called the definitive reason to own an Xbox.
Halo. Halo.
Because humanity was
Halo.
And is worth saving.
Halo.
Next holiday, we will launch Project Scarlet with Halo.
Yes. Of course, you have to. You have to. Yes, Phil. Give us something here. Just a little bit of gameplay. Game engine footage. Okay, I just want a little bit of gameplay.
Love you, Daddy.
And I can't wait to see you.
See you.
And bye-bye.
Finnegan, Echo 216. Can you hear me?
Where's Chief?
This is you in this. Suit. Looks like there's a problem with the servos in your hands. Stay calm. You've been out there a while.
He's calling.
I saw something in here to check your armor's diagnosis.
AI not detected.
No. Oh, easy there, big guy. You'll know.
Status report.
Status report? Something you need to see, Chief. We lost. Lost everything. There's nothing left for us here. Hunting for heroes.
Oh my god, the lights. He just takes out the chip. He's like, you are coming with me. Let's go. Now to recap. Halo Reach. I knew we would be perfect together. And that was right. Dragon Ball Z game, yes.
And that's going to do it, guys.
It,
guys. That is the conclusion of the Microsoft Xbox
see you
press
next,
conference.
Next year,
Microsoft
but I'll
theater.
See you at
time for
the Game Awards in December.
With our panel. So, guys, what did you think?